carcinoid syndrome is characterized by flushing of the type I just described, diarrhea. By the way, the flushing can be provoked by excitement, by alcohol, by certain foods, or emotional factors, or certain medications like epinephrine. But the diarrhea is also watery, usually, sometimes with cramping or discomfort. It's so-called secretory diarrhea. That is, it's not dependent upon eating. If it occurs even if you don't eat, and it can occur at nighttime too. Most diarrheas, except for some of the more severe bacterial causes, are only at their worst when you eat and stop during the night. Other symptoms are asthma, bronchospasm, carcinoid heart disease, which is characterized by ascites, that is fluid in the abdomen, swelling of the feet, fatigue, and particular types of heart murmurs. Other symptoms that may occur less frequent are ulcer and a number of others, which I mentioned before.
Okay.
First of all, those are two different conditions or symptoms. Hot flashes may be another term applied to the facial flushing, but also hot flashes are very often the terms used for referring to menopausal episodes in women of middle age, and certain men. However, there are many other causes for this. It's not specific for carcinoid, although the carcinoid flush, or so-called hot flash,
right,
is noted for at its very beginning to be dry, and many other types of flushing are moist, so that if one's very careful in analyzing the cause, you can use that as a feature to tell the difference. The other symptom, please.
Gastroparesis.
That means paralysis to varying degrees of the contraction of the stomach, which is normal to the stomach mixing the ingredients and propelling it, and especially propelling them on into the intestine. That has many causes. One of the commonest ones is diabetes, and it is not a common or even frequent symptom of carcinoid. In fact, I'm thinking back, I don't believe I've ever seen that as a symptom of carcinoid, and unless the patient had poorly controlled or severe diabetes. Well, advanced to what? To make other symptoms? If untreated, it's usual for it to develop into, along with causing carcinoid heart disease. That indeed, in at least 50% of untreated carcinoid syndrome patients, carcinoid heart disease will develop. Also, in rare instances, pellagra, a deficiency of the vitamin B complex niacin will develop. This is less common nowadays in civilized parts of the world because of the fortification of foods with niacin. No, it's not possible because the tumor is the source of serotonin, which is the major producer of the syndrome. There are, on the other hand, many, many things, other diseases that can cause symptoms like the carcinoid syndrome, namely flushing and diarrhea in particular.
What if you removed the primary tumor in surgery and you felt and you still saw symptoms of carcinoid syndrome? Would that ever occur?
Well, yes, you can remove the primary, but have the hormonal products responsible for the carcinoid syndrome being produced by metastases. So even though the primary tumor is removed, there's still tumor present in the body. And if it's active enough or functional enough, making enough of these hormones to provoke the symptoms, then you can have the syndrome. Well, first of all, carcinoid syndrome is really just a severe example of magnification of the symptoms of carcinoid, and all the features of the syndrome need not be present. For example, flushing and diarrhea, the commonest, flushing perhaps a little bit more frequent, but also we may have asthma due to bronchospasm. We may usually have an enlarged liver because of the metastatic disease in the liver, but not in every single case. We may also have some other features like pellagra, fatigue, certain types of arthritis, duodenal ulcers. These are minor, but the major features are flushing and diarrhea, and sometimes, of course, carcinoid heart disease. So they do not all have to be present. I would have to ask which blood tests and urine tests, because there are quite at least a half a dozen different types, and one test alone of blood and urine is inadequate to be absolutely certain. So other tests would be required. I like that question very much because it recently has been demonstrated that there is a familial form of carcinoid. It's being studied currently, and it's supposed to involve somewhere between as low as 10% and as high as 30% of cases of small intestinal carcinoid. But it is not really acknowledged or seen frequently unless it's really searched for. And there's almost always a family history of other members of the family who've had the carcinoid. So we can only say that when it runs in families, it's quite apparent because several members of the family will have it. Otherwise, it is not an inherited form.
So you think if it's something that runs in your family, let's say your parent has it, and you're starting to show any kind of similar symptoms, it might be best to...
A brother, a cousin, if more than two people in the family or the relations have it, it is certainly suggested, advised that you have studies made for whether you have it too. This has been done in people in whom there have been several members of the family, and indeed a high percentage of other relatives were found to have unknown, previously undetected carcinoids. And when they're found very early, they can be cured by surgical resection.